வெரி குட் மார்னிங். ஆன்பல் ரக்ஷா மந்திரி ஸ்ரீ ராஜ்நாத் சிங்ஜி, ஆன்பல் என்எஸ்ஐ ஸ்ரீ அஜித் தோவல்ஜி, சீஃப் ஆஃப் ஆர்மி ஸ்டாஃப் ஜெனரல் பிபின் ராவத், சீஃப் ஆஃப் நேவல் ஸ்டாஃப் அட்மிரல் கரம்பீர் சிங், சீஃப் ஆஃப் ஏர் ஸ்டாஃப் ஏர் சீஃப் மார்ஷல் ஆர்கேஎஸ் பதூரியா, தி எமினென்ட் பர்சனாலிட்டிஸ் ஹூ ஆர் பிரசன்ட் ஹியர், செக்ரட்டரிஸ் டு கவர்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் இந்தியா, Chairman NTRO, Vice Chiefs, Deputy NSAs, the other eminent personalities who have come from all over the country, from academia and industry, the Director Generals of DRDO, the Directors of the various laboratories of DRDO and corporate directorates, and friends from media, once again, very good morning to all of you. At the outset, let me welcome Honorable Raksha Mantri, who has been rendering continuous support and guidance wholeheartedly for all the endeavors of DRDO. I also welcome very specially NSA Sri Ajit Dovalji for being present here on this 41st Directors Conference of DRDO. The presence of all the chiefs of the services is a moral boost to the entire DRDO scientific community here. I also welcome all the dignitaries who are present here and the eminent personalities from academia, other R&D organizations and other scientific departments. Today is a very important day for the scientific fraternity of the country. Today is the birth anniversary of our famous scientist, former President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. We are holding this conference, today conference of directors of the DRDO, today and tomorrow, coinciding with the birth anniversary of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Last year, on the same day, we have announced an innovation contest, Dare to Dream, open to all the people, individuals and startups, to come out with innovative ideas in the specified areas what we have said. And then we had a large response, huge response. It took a lot of time for the jury to go through the contest and select the final awardees. And today they are here. Honorable Raksha Mantri will be bestowing these awards on those winners today. The theme of the today's conference of the directors is Technology Leadership for Empowering India. Today, with a lot of efforts in the few decades, we have come to a stage where in many areas, we have attained self-reliance. Now today, it's the time that Indian research organizations should become the technology leaders. And the today conference will be putting efforts on that to have the plans and the measures, how we can have systems which are advanced and futuristic systems developed here in the country, which makes the country empowered. So the today's conference will be deliberating on many of these areas. The very second session after the inaugural is synergistic perspective planning, where all the three services will be presenting the requirements and the plans from DRDO what they are looking for. And then, the later way forward, what are the futuristic R&D, what are the futuristic systems, and complex systems what we need to develop will be the areas what we'll be looking into it. Day after tomorrow, first session is the industry collaboration and industry-related policies, what we have already brought in. Couple of policies, two policies Honorable Raksha Mantri will be making them open, important policies towards industry growth, industry interaction. And also we'll be taking a lot of inputs from the industry in that session. Then we have the session where our academic institutions and partners from other R&D organizations will be presenting their perspective and how the synergy can be DRDO and academic institutions can be obtained. Later we have an important session which where the finance, purchases and other measures, how it can be efficiently be managed. And finally the session, the two-day conference will be concluding with presentations from young scientists of DRDO. In the last 2 years, we have a lot of achievements. A couple of them I will be narrating here. The most important one, on 27th of March this year, we have conducted successfully an anti-satellite mission by neutralizing a satellite at about 300 kilometers orbit. And we became the fourth nation in the world who have done such an experiment in the world. This year, we got the final operational clearance for the LCA, paving the way for the production of light combat aircraft. The AEWC, second aircraft, has been completely developed and has been handed over to the Air Force. The long-range surface-to-air missile has successfully completed its operational trial, and again, the production of that system is in advanced stage, completing the almost the numbers what is required. Then the Agni-5 has gone through three successful trials in the year 2018, paving the way for induction of that system. And the BrahMos missile air version has been successfully flight tested from the Su-30 aircraft. And the Astra air-to-air missile, which is BVR, beyond visual range missile, has successfully gone through all the trials. And the NAG missile has also successfully gone through its user trials. The smart anti-airfield weapon has again gone through the trials successfully. The main battle tank Arjun Mark 1A has gone through the trials successfully again. The military load class 46 meters modular bridge has successfully completed trials. The Altas has completed UAT from INS Shraddha, and the medium power radar has completed its trials. The low level transportable radar Ashwini has completed successfully trials. The software defined radio for the naval applications has completed in two versions. These are some of the achievements which I mentioned here, and many more to come. And in the coming year, we will be having the targets of completing the trials of ATACs, QRSAM, Helena, Dhruvastra, Guided Pinaka, ALWT, ASCS, ASA radar for LCA, IMSAS, VOMA, and Samudrika. These are some of the targets which I won't be able to narrate. Many of them, a lot more are there, which we have as targets in the coming years. Also, a lot of R&D projects have been taken up, which are for the futuristic technology developments, which we are working with various academic institutes and other R&D organizations. The centers which have been established at various IITs, IIT Delhi, IIT Mumbai, IIT Chennai, Jadavpur University, Bharatiya University, Hyderabad Central University, many of them working on the futuristic technologies are in progressing various futuristic technologies well there. With the armed forces, participation of them in all the project management and reviews, the synergy between armed forces is now is going on very excellently, and lots of requirements coming from the services which various laboratories are taking up. And in fact, the services have been posting many service officers a part of the projects here, and in fact the presence of the three service chiefs here itself shows the synergy and gives the boost to the scientists here in DRDO. I assure Honorable Raksha Mantri and the three service chiefs that we will live up to your expectations. We will do the research and development what are required for the futuristic weapons, state-of-the-art weapons, what you're looking for, and we will strive for meeting all the requirements in the coming years. I wish the conference a great success. I wish all the scientists to deliberate very seriously on all the measures what need to be taken to ensure DRDO is developing state-of-the-art and futuristic weapons. All the best. Thank you. Thank you very much.